Traders, I'm not going to continue trading. As you can see here, I've got a red day. I have a loser in Boeing, which was a big mistake because shorted it where I should have, had my target where I should have, did not take my partial where I should have also taken my partial, and Boeing went against me, and end result, I'm out. Disney was a great trade. I mean, really loved that long trade, and actually still riding it for more than 3 points. So Disney is doing really, really good. Again, that's a stock that everybody's watching. Disney's up today quite a bit. And as you can see, it started with a gap up, pulled back down. Trigger point was always before it moves to a new high. You always want to take it at the point where you expect it to move to a new high. As I mentioned last time, it's the point of 80%, the point where you think that once it's going to go through, that would be the point where it's probably, in your opinion, that's the 80% going to move over the highs. So I went long at the point where I thought it should go and move over the highs, and the rest is history, because Disney really worked out fine. Now, you have to remember, when a big company like Disney, who everybody's watching, is gapping up, then coming down, people are looking for these pullbacks. People are looking for the breakouts. There's a lot of people who would buy with you. You want to buy before the crowd. You want to buy at the point of where you expect it to move over the highs. But an interesting stock like Disney, where everybody who is watching should do well, and Disney did do very good. I have an unpleasant loser in HZNP, which has just decided to move sideways. I'm not even going to look at the chart again. I mean, it was a very big disappointment. Space was a relatively small loss. What I did like is my winner in NKLA. I'm showing you a loser here. That's because I had two losing trades in NKLA and one winner in NKLA, and I'm still riding 100 shares. So the interesting part about this one, which I want to discuss a little bit more, is the fact that it started with a gap down today, and you would expect a stock that starts with a gap down to continue coming down. And it's quite rare when a stock is starting with a gap down of 20% or so that it won't do so. I mean, the bigger the gap and go should be. And it did start very low, and then I did short it where I should have. I mean, usually trades like this would work out great. It did not. It bounced back up. But another rule is you wait for another drop. And we did wait for another drop. And we did have a second chance because, again, usually stocks like that would fail. At this time, two trades did not work out fine. So I had a second loser in NKLA. And, you know, it's not exactly my cup of tea of trading, not exactly the kind of trades I personally take, but I did decide to go long. I did hesitate quite a lot before going long here at 33.80. And that was my third and third trade in NKLA and the winner. That's why my loss in NKLA, although I had two losing trades, was not as big as it could have been because of my winning trade. So the thing is, when you see a stock that is going against you, it does not count for every trade you see, and I very rarely do that, but I did it today. When you see a stock going against you twice, you kind of get the idea you were wrong first time, you were wrong the second time, and at the third time, when you see it trying to move over the highs, and again, the point of anticipation is going to move over the highs, that's the point where you should take a trade. That's the point where you should go long. So I had my share of losers today. Mistakes too. I don't consider NKLA two trades I had as something that I did wrong. I did not do wrong. Usually that would have been, I mean, NKLA was my main target trade today. It was my biggest candidate today. I mean, a drop like that, but it did not work out, not because I did something wrong, it's because it just didn't work out. And that's the whole thing about trading. Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't. But if you're successful enough and do it at 65% success to trade or more, then you've got yourself, you're probably going to make money regularly. So the thing about NKLA was the fact that I took it long, which was a bit different. And then, you know, at the point I took it long was the point where it really kind of proved to me that it's really, really, really want to move the other way. And I'm kind of like this trade. So that's it. I've got a losing day today. Unpleasant. But I did start great with over $20,000 my first trading session this week, and then another small winner yesterday. And well, that's the life of a trader. So I gave back some of my profits, not much, and I'm very I hope we're gonna have a green day tomorrow too. So just have fun the rest of your day. I did enjoy this, although I did lose some money today, but it was an interesting session. So I'll see you all tomorrow. Enjoy, have fun, and try and do your best. Bye, traders. Thank you for watching our video. The material was taken from The Market Whisperer, my Amazon best-selling book. This essential guide to stock trading is ideal for those with no background or experience in stock trading. Click here to read the 200-page part one of this book absolutely free. If you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel where you can view many more stock trading videos. Questions or comments, please submit them below.